So students, we are continuing our class. So page number 56, all of you open your textbooks, page number 56. So you see your notebook, where we stopped, how many problems we completed, and now which problem we have to continue. Thus, just look at it, and when you are charting, write your branch names. If you are not understanding the problem, you just don't hesitate, just write we did not understood, not understood, just not understood. If you have understood, yes understood, over, yes followed, understood, not understood, anything you can mention, you mention your branch name. So this is the second chapter, linear equations in one variable, exercise 2.5. So this is the first question. In that, all 11 bits we completed, 12th one you write down. 12th one you write down. (3t + 1/16) (-2t - 3/7), (t + 3/8), (3t - 1/14). This is the question. Students, you know, take LCM on the left side, LCM on the right side. Old Safilguda branch. Somebody got answer also. Very good, congratulations. So, LCM. It is a big problem actually, lengthy. LCM 16 × 7. 16, 7 times 7 × 3t + 1 - 7, 16 times, so 16 × 2t - 3. 8 × 14 LCM. 2 × 4s are 2, 7s are 56 LCM. Take the LCM of 8 and 14. 8, 14, 2, 4s are 8, 2, 7s are 14. 2 × 4 × 7. 2 × 4, 8. 8 × 7, 56. 8 how many times? 7 times. 8, 7 times. 8, 7s are 56. 7 times. 7 × t + 3 + 14, 4 times. 14, 4 times. 4 × 3t - 1. This is nothing but simply taking the LCM. You know how to add the fractions, how to subtract the fractions. To subtract or add the fractions, we have to take the LCM. 16, 7 LCM is 16 × 7, 112. 16, 7 times 7 × 3t + 1. 7, 16 times 16 × 2t - 3. And 8, 14 LCM is 56. So 8, 7 times 7 × t + 3. 14, 4 times 4 × 3t - 1. Do it. Seven threes are 21. 7 × 3, 21. 7 × 1, 7. 16 × 2s are 32. 16 × 3s are 48. 7 × 3, 21, 7 × 1, 7, 16 × 2, 32, (-×-+), 16 × 3s are 48. 7, 70. 7 × 3, 21. 4 × 3s are 12. 4 × 1, 4. Actually 56 × 2s are 112. These two get cancelled. 56 ones are 56, 2s are, we can write 2 here, or I will write like this. So 56, 112, I will take that side, 112. Here it is divide, it will become multiplication. Of course, we can do cross multiplication also, but because this is a big number, let us cancel it, let us remove it. So instead of keeping multiplying, it becomes big, big number. So I will cancel it, because exactly two times it will get cancelled. Directly also I can cancel, but if you may get confused. So denominator, divide means it will become what? Multiplication. If it is in the denominator, it becomes a multiplication. So this is 70 plus 7 into 3, 21, 4 into 3, 12, 4 into 1, 4 by 56. Divide means into 56 1 the 56 2 the 56 2 the 1 12. 21 minus 32 minus 11. 7 plus 48 55. 21 minus 32 is minus 11. 7 plus 48 55. 7 plus 12, 7 plus 12 is 19t. 21 minus 4 is 17. Into 2 is there. Into 2 is there. Into 2. 56 2 times. Multiply with 2. Twos are 38, 17 twos are 34, 2 into 19, 38, 2 into 17, 34, all t terms one side, constants on the other side, minus 11t plus 38 this side, minus 38, 34 plus 55 that side, minus 55, do the simplification and get the answer. Minus 40, 90, minus 34, minus 25 is 21, minus minus cancel, t is equal to 21 by 49. Minus minus cancel, it is in into means it will be in the denominator, so 21 by 49.
Kushai Guda, so
what is the answer? 7 table. 7 table, 7 threes are 7 sevens. 7 threes are 21, 7 sevens are 49. So, 7 table you cancel. 7 table.
Students, complete it and read the second problem.
Here nothing to explain, only simplification, simplification, that's all. No concept, no formula, nothing. After copying it, then write the second problem. We have total 13 problems in this. So now we are at second, more 11 problems. So that we can complete this chapter, which is a very difficult chapter. Again, theory problems, difficult problems, no rule, no formula, no concept, different problems with a different model. Second problem, what a number is that of which third part exceeds the fifth part by 4?
let the required number is equal to x. We have to find a number, let the number be x. What is meant by third part? Third part means by three. Suppose say x is a number, third part means 1/3. Third part means 1/3. Third part means 1/3. 1/3, that means by 3. Fifth part means by 5. Suppose if you have 100, what is the fourth part of it? That means divide into 4 parts. So each part is 25. Fourth part, quarter, fourth part, like that. So third part means by 3. Fifth part means by 5. Third part divide into 3 parts. Dividing means by 3. Fifth part means divide into 5 parts. So divide by 5. That's all. Now, see here. It's a third part. Third part is x by 3. Fifth part, x by 5. Third part is x by 3. Fifth part is x by 5. Third part, see here. Third part, x by 3. Fifth part, x by 5. Exceeds means, what is the meaning of exceed? Exceed means difference or greater. This is greater than this. So the difference is 4, exceeds 4. See here, given that, what is a given condition? Third part is greater than fifth part by how much? 4. It is given. Given that, given in the problem. This is third, number is x. What is its third part? X by 3. What is its fifth part? X by 5. So this is greater, third part is greater, exceeds means more. How much more? 4. How to get that more? More means this minus this. So the difference is, this is greater than this by this much difference. So it is given in the problem. Now onwards we can. So you have to understand this up to here. I took the number as x, third part means by 3, fifth part means by 5. What is the difference? 4. Where is that 4? It is given in the question. Given. Now, LCM 3, 5 is a 15. 3, 5 is a 15. 3, 5 times 5x. 5, 3 times 3x. 3, 5 is a 15 LCM. 3, 5 times 5 into x, 5x. 5, 3 times 3 into x, 3x. So 5x minus 3x is 2x. Now see here, x is equal to 4. 15 is in division, so it will become multiplication. Wherever division is there, it will be in 2. Here 2 is in 2, so it will be in the denominator. 15 will go up, 2 will come down. 15 is in 2. 2 is by. 2 2's up. 2 2's up. 2 into 15, 30. This is the procedure. Followed or not? Once again read the question and see the process. 1/3 means x by 3, 1/5 means by x by 5. Third part x by 3, fifth part x by 5. So the difference is given as 4. It is given in the question. That's third problem. third problem and understand it.
The difference between two positive numbers is 36.
Difference between two positive numbers is 36. Difference is 36.
Difference is 36. The quotient when the one integer is divided by other is 4. Find the integer. See here. I will give one simple example.
Difference is equal to 10. Suppose difference is 10.
Say one number is 5. What is the other number? Difference is 10. Difference between two numbers is 10. Suppose one number is 5. Other number will be 15 because difference should be 10. No? Difference. Difference between two numbers is 10 means, suppose if one number is 5, other number will be 10 plus 5, 15. Or minus also we can take. Suppose if this is known, how to get this number? 15 minus 10, like that. So, difference is 10 means, if one number is x, other number will be x plus 10, like that. So, first step you have to remember. Difference between two numbers is 10 means, if you know one number, you can tell other number. Suppose 40 is one number. So, what is the other number? Difference should be 10, no? If 40 is the other number, one number, next number will be 50. 50 minus 40 is 10, like that. Or next number will be 30 also. 40 minus 30 is also 10. Difference means subtraction. So, that means, what we are, if you know this number, how we are getting this? 40 plus 10, like that. So let the two numbers be, I am taking the first number as x. First number is x. What is the second number? X plus that difference. So second number is x plus 36. That's this step, if you remember, then problem will be over. Difference is 36. If one number is x, other number will be x plus 36. See the difference. What is the difference between these two? This minus this is how much xx cancel? 36 only. Difference should be 36. If one number is x, other number is x plus 36. Now what happens?
Don't write.
The quotient when one integer is, this one number is divided by other. One number is divided by other. So, see, two methods I told. See, suppose if this is a 10, don't write. Suppose one number is 40, difference should be 10. So, next number will be 50. Why? Because 40, this 50 minus 10 is 40, like that. Or 40 plus 10 is 50. Difference 10 means this is 40, this is 50. Or if this is 40, this will be 30. Two methods. Anyone is correct. Suppose if we take x plus 36, that is one method. Or, so, see, this is 50, it may be 30. Two cases. So, 40, how to get 50? 40 plus 10. Or, 40 minus 10 also correct. Because, first number may be greater, second number may be greater. We don't know. 40, 50 is also correct. 40, 30 is also correct. So, therefore, two cases. So, whether you add or subtract. So, both are correct. But in the textbook hint, it is given as x minus 36. Anyway, you will get the same process. So, one number is x, other number is x minus 36, which is given. Plus or minus. Next number will be, if it is greater than this, you add. Less than this, you subtract. Same. So, let the numbers be x comma x minus 36. What is given? Read the question now. First number is, one integer is divided by, one integer is, one number is divided by the second number. First number is divided by the second number. Answer is 4. Answer is 4 given.
it is given the textbook. First number divided by the second number, answer is 4. You can take the numbers as x and x plus 36 or x and x minus 36. Both ways correct. But in the textbook hint it is given x minus 36. Let us do it. First number divided by the second number, what is the answer? 4. Read the question. That's all. Over. Now cross multiply. If there is nothing, or take this to the right side. Take it into the right side. 4 into x minus 36. That's denominator taken to the right side. Denominator means it will become into. It is divide, it will become into. See here. X is equal to 4x. 4 into 36. 4, 6 are 24. 2, 144. 4 into 36, 144. Bring all x terms on the left side. All x on left side. Already x is here. Plus 4x this side, minus 4x is equal to minus 144, same, minus 144, same, plus 4x this side, minus 4x. So, minus 3x is equal to minus 144, minus, minus, cancel, 144 by, it is into means it will be the denominator. So, this is 3 cancel, 144 by 3, you can cancel, you know how to simplify, 3, 4 is 12. 12 means 2 remains. 2, 4, 24, 3, 8 are. This is the process. So, what is the question? Find the integers. So, 1 is x. X is 48. Next is x minus 36. So, 48 minus 36 is 12. So, the numbers are 48 and 12 answer. 48 and 12. See the difference. The difference is 36 means if 1 is x, difference means minus. So next will be x minus 36. Difference means the difference between these two. Suppose if this is a bigger number, this will be x minus 36. If it is a small, if it is a smaller number, x plus 36. Anyway, you take. So x minus 36. One number is x, other number is x minus 36. Otherwise, you remember like this. Difference means minus. That's all. First number divided by the second number, answer is 4. It is given in the textbook. First number divided by the second number, answer is 4. So, that's all. Now onwards, it is very simple. Take this to the right side. It is in the denominator. It will become into. 4 into x. 4x. 4 into 36. 144. Plus 4x this side. Minus 4x. X minus 4x minus 3x minus 144 minus minus cancel by 3. 3 48 times. So x is 48. Next is x minus 36. No, 48 minus 36 is 12. So what are the number, two numbers? 48 and 12. Write down and practice. After completing this, Charminar branch, fourth question, you read it one time, two times, three times, you like that you read. See here, numerator of a fraction is scoreless, then the denominator. Suppose fraction means it will have numerator, and this one is called numerator, this is called denominator. You know, this is numerator, this is denominator. Numerator is 4 less than the denominator. Suppose if it is 12, what is the numerator? 4 less. 4 less. That means 8. 4 less than. That means 12 minus 4. Suppose denominator is 12. What will be the numerator? Numerator is 4 less than the denominator. 4 less means 12 minus 4, 8. Numerator is 8. Like that. So, I gave example, but we don't know the denominator, we don't know the numerator. Suppose denominator say x. Tell me the numerator. Tell me the numerator. Numerator is 4 less than the denominator. 4 less. If this is x, x minus 4. If this is x, numerator is 4 less. 4 less. X minus 4. See here. Let the numerator is equal to X. Denominator is equal to X. The numerator is equal to numerator is 4 less than the denominator. If it is x, this will be x minus 4. 4 less than the denominator. Numerator is 4 less than the denominator. Denominator x means 4 less means x minus 4. Less means minus. If this is x, this will be 4 less. It is given. Numerator is 4 less than the denominator. It is given in the textbook. Numerator is, if denominator is x, numerator is 4 less. That means x minus 4. Now, what happened? If 1 is added to, then what is the fraction? See here. Then what is the fraction here? Numerator x, denominator is x minus 4. Okay, sorry. Numerator is x minus 4, denominator is x. This is a fraction. Simple. Numerator is 4 less than the denominator. If denominator is x, 4 less means x minus 4. This is the fraction. Then what happens? If 1 is added to, see the question, both numerator and denominator. 1 is added to both the numerator and denominator. 1 is added to both the numerator and denominator. What is the fraction here? Don't write. This is the fraction. This is the fraction. What happened? 1 is added to both numerator and denominator. Numerator 1 is added. Denominator 1 is added. So, in between a small net disturbances, okay, no problem. So, what happened? This is the fraction. Numerator, denominator is x, numerator is 4 less than the denominator. So, if this is x, this is x minus 4. No, this is a simple fraction. But what happened? 1 is added to numerator and also denominator. Same fraction. Add 1 to the numerator, add 1 to the denominator. It is given in the textbook. If 1 is added to both numerator and denominator, plus 1, plus 1. this becomes 1 by 2. This becomes 1 by 2. Given. It is given in the problem. If I add 1 to the numerator, 1 to the denominator, I will get a new fraction. No? It is equal to 1 by 2. It is given. Now we got the equation. Solve it and get x value. See here. Cross multiplication. Or I will write one more term. X minus 3 by x plus 1. Cross multiplication. See here. Denominator into numerator. 2 into x minus 3. 2 into x minus 3. 1 into x plus 1. 2 into x minus 3, 1 into x plus 1. Denominator into numerator, numerator into denominator. Cross multiplication, this into this, this into this. 2 into x minus 3, 1 into x plus 1. Do and get x value. 2x minus 2, 3 is a 6. 1 into x, 1x plus 1. 2x plus x this side, minus x. 1 minus 6 that side plus 6. See here. 2 into x, 2x, 2 into 3, 6, 1 into x, 1x, 1 into 1, 1. 2x minus x minus 6 this side plus 6. 2x minus x is how much? 2x minus x is x. 1 plus 6 is 7. So therefore, the fraction is, see here, what is our answer? Actually, what is our fraction? X minus 4 by x. Original fraction. For numerator is 4 less than the denominator means, what is the fraction? X minus 4 by x. What is x value? Now we got x value, no? So substitute. X value 4. 4 minus, x value is 7. 7 minus 4 by 7. So the answer is 3 by 7. Denominator x, numerator is 4 less. Less means minus. This is the fraction, but 1 is added to the numerator and denominator. Then answer is 1 by 2. It is given in the textbook. So minus 4 plus 1 is minus 3 by x plus 1. Cross multiplication, 2 into x minus 3, 1 into x plus 1. 2 into x, 2x, 2 into 3, 6, 1 into x, 1 into 1, plus x this side, minus 6 that side, plus 6, 1 plus 6 is 7, 2x minus x is x is equal to 7 we got, but we have to write the fraction. What is the fraction? X minus 4 by x, this is the fraction. So x is 7 means 7 minus 4, 3 by denominator x is 7, 3 by 7 answer. So we completed up to 4 problems and no hurry, fifth one we will do it tomorrow because these are difficult problems. Second, third, fourth, three problems are difficult, but you practice. Not practicing, you must read the question, understand why I took like this, why I, how I got this, and why this added, why it becomes 1 by 2. After this, anyway, you know, up to here, why it is happening, each step, why it is happening. Read the question and analyze the step. So practice it, and we have total 39 more problems. It may take 2 days or 3 days, we will complete this chapter. Thank you students, practice these problems, and let us stop here. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.